addition of decimals. In order to add decimal numbers, we need to first check if the numbers have same number of digits to the right of the decimal point. In case of the addition of 3.5 and 28.23, 3.5 has 1, 28.23 has 2 digits to the right of the decimal points. Then we need to write one number on top of other, lining up the decimal points vertically, so that the ones plus with all other pluses of them line up in a column. In 3.5, the ones plus is occupied by 3, which is the place immediately before the decimal point. Similarly, in 28.23, the ones place is occupied by 8. Thus, the decimal points are lined up vertically with respect to the ones place. Then we need to add zeros to the empty number places until the numbers do have same number of digits. If we add zeros to the empty number places, then both the numbers have 4 digits. Finally, we need to add them as done with the whole numbers and bring the decimal point straight down. Here, 0 plus 3 equals 3, 5 plus 2 equals 7, 3 plus 8 is equal to 11, where we have 1 in 1's place and we have another 1 in 10's place. So firstly, we need to write the 1 from 1's place of 11, and the 1 from 10's place will be added with 2, because 2 from 28 is also the digit that occupies a 10's place. So 1 plus 2 is equal to 3, and then we need to bring the decimal point straight down. Thus, the result of the addition is 31.73. In order to subtract one decimal number from another, we need to check if the numbers have the same number of digits to the right of the decimal point. Then we need to write the greater number on top of the smaller one, lining up the decimal points vertically, so that the ones plus with all other pluses of them line up in a column. In case of the subtraction of 3.5 from 28.23, we can see that 28.23 is greater than 3.5, therefore we can write 28.23 on top of 3.5, where the decimal points are lined up vertically with respect to the ones place. Then we need to add zeros to the empty number places, so that both the numbers have 4 digits. Finally, we need to subtract one from another as done with the whole numbers and bring the decimal point straight down. Here, 3 minus 0 equals 3. As 5 is greater than 2, we will bring 1 from 8 and we will get 12, and 12 minus 5 is equal to 7. Now, as we have borrowed 1 from 8, we have 7 here instead of 8, and 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. Finally, 2 minus 0 equals 2, and we need to bring the decimal point straight down. Thus, the subtraction results in 24.73. Multiplication of decimals. In order to multiply two decimal numbers, we need to first shift the decimal points to the right to make the decimal numbers act as integers. Then we need to sum the total number of places the decimal points get shifted together in the numbers to the right. In case of the multiplication of 2.46 and 1.5, we need to shift the decimal points 2 places in 2.46 and 1 place in 1.5 to get the integers 246 and 15. Thus, the decimal points get shifted total 3 places in case of 2.46 and 1.5 to the right. Now we need to multiply the numbers as done with the whole numbers. Here 5 times 6 equals 30, so we have 3 to be added. 5 times 4 is equal to 20 plus 3 is equal to 23. We have 2 to be added. 5 times 2 is equal to 10. 10 plus 2 equals 12. Then we have 6 times 1 equals 6. 4 times 1 is equal to 4. 2 times 1 is equal to 2. Now we need to add the different products, where 0, 6 plus 3 is equal to 9, 4 plus 2 results in 6, 2 plus 1 is equal to 3. Finally, we need to shift the decimal point same amount to the left. So we need to shift the decimal point 3 places to the left. 1, 2, 3. So we will have a decimal point in between 3 and 6. Where the answer will have as many places after the decimal point as the two original number combined. The two original number combined 3 places, and we have 3 places after the decimal point. So the multiplication results in 3.690. Division of decimals. In case of the division of decimals, we need to first multiply the divisor by a power of 10 to make the divisor a whole number. And we need to multiply the dividend by the same power of 10 in case of the division of 9.68 by 3.2. If we multiply 3.2 by 10, we'll get the whole number 32. And if we multiply the dividend 9.68 by the same power of 10, we'll get 96.8. Now, we need to divide 96.8 by 32, where 32 is a whole number. 32 will go 3 times into 96. Thus, we have a remainder of 0, and we need to bring down the next digit, which is 8. And 8 is less than 32. Therefore, we need to bring down a 0 to the remainder, because adding 0 placeholder will not change the value of a decimal. Here, 32 is less than 80. And as we have bring down two numbers together, so we will have to put a 0 in the quotient. And we need to place the decimal point in the quotient during the long division directly above the decimal point in the dividend. Now 32 will go 2 times into 80, which results in 64, and the remainder is 16. As 16 is less than 32, we need to bring down an additional 0, which gives us 160, and 32 will go 5 times into 160 with a remainder of 0 to complete the process. Thus, we need to divide the dividend by the whole number divisor to find the quotient and our result. Thus, the division results in 3.025. Decimal irrational numbers. A non-terminating, non-repeating decimal is a decimal number that continues endlessly with no group of digits repeating endlessly. Decimals of this type cannot be represented as fractions, and as a result, they are irrational numbers. For example, pi, a square root of 2, Euler number. Thanks for watching. Perceive, persevere, practice. Do not forget to like, subscribe, and share. Thanking you from High Study Prep.